students, in today's video we will be seeing about the religious conditions, art and decline of Indus civilization. So let us see about the religious condition. We get information about the Indus religious life from seals, terracotta figurines and images of stones. So mostly we get information about Indus civilization from archaeological sources. As we have already discussed, we get much information about Indus civilization from archaeological sources. The main reason was that whatever was written was not deciphered to the acceptance of all. So about religion, if you see, we get information about Indus religion from their seals, from terracotta figurines and from some images of stones. From all these, historians have understood that their main deity was Mother Goddess. They worshipped Mother Goddess as their main deity. Shiva also was worshipped in the form of Pashupati and Linga. So from the remains, historians have also come to the conclusion that Shiva was worshipped in the form of Pashupati and Linga. They also worshipped trees, animals, birds and serpents. That is, they were nature worshippers. They worshipped trees, animals, birds and serpents, and they also feared demons. That is, they had fear of the evil spirits or the evil. So that much information we get about the religious condition of Indus civilization. Next is art and sculpture. Indus people had a good aesthetic taste. They had a good taste of beauty. They appreciated beauty. Whatever was beautiful, they knew how to appreciate that. Their seals, figurines, pottery, etc. had attractive designs. They were decorated with attractive designs. The idol of dancing girl, statue of a bearded man, figures of Pashupati, terracotta toys, and jewelry, all are examples of their artistic skills. Whatever they made, they decorated it and they made it attractive. So that some examples are given: the idol of a dancing girl, the statue of a bearded man, figures of Pashupati, terracotta toys and jewelry, all are examples of their artistic skills. So if you see the religious condition, we get information about Indus religion from their seals, terracotta figurines and images of stones. Their main deity was Mother Goddess. Shiva was worshipped in the form of Pashupati and Linga. They also worshipped trees, animals, birds and serpents, and they also feared demons. Regarding their art and sculpture, Indus people had a good aesthetic taste. Their seals, figures, pottery, etc. had very attractive designs. Some examples are the idol of a dancing girl, statue of a bearded man, figures of Pashupati, terracotta toys and jewelry are examples of their artistic skills. Next, let us see about their seals and the scripts. We have seen so many examples of Indus seals in different topics. So what are seals? More than 3000 Indus seals have been found. We already have studied that it is from seals that we get idea of their religion. It is from seals that we get idea of their artistic taste. So more than 3000 seals have been found in Indus civilization. These seals were made of either terracotta, ivory, stone, etc. Most of it were square or rectangular shape and they were very small. Like the normal seals which you see, the seals were square or rectangular in shape and they were small. Most of the seals had finely engraved figures of various animals like bull, unicorn, elephant and even human figures were also engraved on the seals. So it is from such seals that they get idea about their religion or art and art and sculpture. From these seals they get idea. So most of the seals had finely engraved figures of various animals like bull, unicorn, elephant and some even had human engravings. And some had pictographic writings on them. Pictographic writings means it is like pictures, the letters will be like pictures. This pictographic writing has not been deciphered to the acceptance of all. That is what we have already discussed, that Indo-civilization script was a kind of pictographic script. But this script has not yet been deciphered to the acceptance of all. That is, some have claimed to have deciphered the script, but it is not accepted by everyone. It seems that the direction of writing was right to left. Unlike what we write is from left to right, it is believed that the Indus people, their direction of writing was from right to left. So they had more than 3000 seals. They were made of either terracotta, ivory or stone. Most of them were either square or rectangular in shape and they were small. Most of the seals had finely engraved figures of various animals like bull, unicorn, elephants. Some even had engravings of humans and some had pictographic writings on them. This writing has not yet been deciphered to the acceptance of all, and it seems that the direction of writing was right to left. The next topic is the end of Indus civilization. We have learned all the details about Indus civilization till now, that is political, social, economic, religious, art and sculpture, etc. Now, how did this civilization came to an end? So let us see the points. Historians have said about many reasons for the decline of the civilization. The rivers must have changed their course and destroyed the cities. One reason must have been the change in the course of river. We all know that Indus civilization happened on the banks of river Sindhu. So Indus civilization end must have been because of the change in the direction of the river, and this must have destroyed the cities. The next possible cause was the drifting of rivers must have made the place unfertile. When the river was there, the area was very fertile and agriculture was progressing in that area, and that made the civilization flourish. But when the river changed its course, it must have made the place unfertile, and that also must have been a cause for the end of Indus civilization. That is, drifting of the course of river must have made the place unfertile. The next reason was continuous flood also must have been a cause for the decline of civilization. Some historians are of the opinion that the spread of epidemics must have wiped out the population. That is, some epidemics, some diseases must have spread there, and that because of that epidemics, the population must have been completely wiped off. That is the opinion of some historians. A decrease in the amount of rainfall must have turned the Indus land into desert. That was another reason, that is decrease in amount of rainfall. Invaders must have been attracted by the wealth of Indus civilization, and their attack can also be a cause for Indus civilization. And according to some recent research, it is said that the decline of Indus civilization was not a sudden process, it was a gradual process. That is, it did not come to an end suddenly, but it was a gradual process. Slowly, it came to an end. So, all these must have been the reasons for the decline of Indus civilization. That is, historians have said many reasons for the decline of Indus civilization. The first was the rivers must have changed their course and this must have ruined the cities. Next was the drifting of the river must have made the place unfertile. Continuous floods must have been another cause. And some historians say that some kind of epidemics must have wiped out the population. A decrease in amount of rainfall must have turned the land into desert. One more reason was invaders must have been attracted by their wealth and they must have attacked, and this must have been a cause for the decline. And according to some recent research, the decline of Indus civilization was a gradual process. Now let us see some important questions from the topic which we have studied today. Mention the important deity of Indus people, Mother Goddess and Pashupati. Two important deities are Mother Goddess and Pashupati. Question number 2. Mention any two causes which brought an end to Indus civilization. change in the course of river, continuous flood, spread of epidemics, attack by invaders, any two from these causes you can write. So the causes which brought an end to the Indus civilization, change in the course of the river, continuous flood, spread of epidemics and attack by invaders. So with this we finish this chapter about Indus civilization. I hope you have understood the complete topic very clearly. Please go through the topic, and if there is any doubt, please feel free to ask your doubts in the comment section in the video. I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have liked it, please do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. I hope to see you soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.